Hi, we will look at another set of solutions for CAT 19 slot 2 quant paper. Recommend you to try to solve on your own before you look at the solution. So we use 405 cc of iron, 780 cc of aluminium and 351 cc of copper. Number of solid right circular cylinders. These cylinders have the same volume and each of these has radius 3. So first of all, they have same volume. And we want to keep number of cylinders minimum. If you want to keep number of cylinders minimum, the volume has to be maximum, because number into volume per cylinder will be equal to total volume. And since total volume is constant, if I want to reduce this number of cylinders, the volume per cylinder has to be maximum. That means the volume per cylinder has to be HCF of these three numbers. So let's look at HCF of these three numbers, highest common factor, because it has to be a factor of these numbers. If I want integer number of cylinders, it has to be factor of these. If you look at it, all are multiples of 9 because sum of digits are multiple of 9. So let's look at 9. So 9 4s are 36, 5s are 45. 9 8s are 72, 9s are 63. Sorry, 7s are 63. 9 3s are 27 and 9s are 81. Now you can make out goes in 3, so this will be 15, this will be 29 and this will be 13, right? So I know that the common value is 9 3s are 27, that is the common HCF, highest common factor. So volume of each cylinder is 27 and number of cylinders are, if you add it up, 57. So 20 30 40 49 plus 5, 54, 54 plus 3, 57 cylinders. Now, if there are volume of each cylinder is 27 and we know radius is 3, the volume of each cylinder is pi r square h, which should be equal to 27. I know r is 3, so h will be 27 upon pi into 3 square, which is 3 upon pi is the height. The 3 upon pi is the height of each cylinder. Now, what is the surface volume of each cylinder? It's 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. If I look at it, 2 pi r is 3, h is 3 upon pi plus 2 pi 3 square. If I take this up, pi pi gets cancelled. This is 18 plus 18 pi. And the 57 is a cylinder, so you have to multiply by 57. If you do 18 into 57, you should get 1026. And 57 into 20 will give you 1140 minus 57 into 2 minus 114 should give you 1026. So 1026, 1 plus pi, which is A option. You can eliminate two options actually directly, because the moment you know that the radius is 3, so area will be pi r square of the base, which is 9 pi. That means, and even if the height is there, there is a r in the height, so that also has to be multiple of 3. I mean, if you look at 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h, okay, there is r in common, r will automatically be common, so you know it should be a multiple of 3. You will realize that only a and d, 1044 and 1026, are multiple of 3. 8464 and 928 are not a multiple of 3. Technically, you can eliminate like that. But yes, if you want, you can solve it. Find a number of cylinders, find the surface area of each cylinder, and then try to get the answer. That will also do in terms of getting the answer. Either way, you can eliminate the option or you can try to solve it. Okay. Here, I can make out that the answer cannot be more than 1, because if it's 1, for example, if I take x as 1, what do I get? If I take x as 1, I get 2 raised to 6 plus 2 raised to 5, which is definitely more than 0. So that means only possible way it should be x should be less than 1. But if you look at it properly, log 9 to the base 2 is more than 1, not possible. Log of 27 to the base 2 is more than 1, not possible. So I'm left with B and D option for sure. Now, let me see approximately what's the value of B and what's the value of D. If you look at, if you know log to the base 2 raised to n will be n log 2 to the base 2, which is n. If you look at 3, should be approximately 2 raised to 1 to 2 raised to 2, between 2 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 2. So it should be approximately 1.5. Okay, 2 raised to 1.5. I'm just taking approximate 1.5. So the value of b will be 1.5 upon 3, which is half. And if I take d, 7 is almost 2 cube. 7 is almost 2 cube. So that means in this case, log to the base 2 cube will be almost 3. 3 upon 3 is almost 1. Okay, little less than 1, but almost 1. Now let me substitute half and check out. If I put half out here in this equation, 2 raised to 6 into half plus 2 raised to 3 into half plus 2 minus 21, which is 2 cube plus 2 raised to 3.5. 2 cube is 8. 2 raised to 3.5 will be slightly more than 8 and less than 16. Let's say 12. So this becomes almost 0. This satisfies. So automatically I know B is the answer. Almost 1 doesn't satisfy. Ruled out. There's one more way of doing from here. Once you get shortlist 2 options, there's one more way of doing. Substitute the option. Once you substitute the option, you should know there's a formula for log. Look at a basic formula for log. The formula for log is n raised to log to the base n r will be equal to r. Something like that. So I'll just tell you how it goes. Suppose I substitute the value formula as, I substitute this value out here on top. So what do you get? Well, this is basically nothing but log to the base 2, 3 raised to 1 by 3. That's what this is. Put it out here. So 2 raised to 6 log to the base 2, 3 raised to 1 by 3. If 6 goes on top, it becomes 2 raised to log to the base 2, 3 square, which is 2 raised to log to the base 2, 9. So this will come as 9 as the answer by this formula R. Plus, if I look at next one, 2 raised to 3 log to the base 2, 3 raised to 1 by 3 plus 2. So this becomes 2 raised to log to the base 2, 3 plus, this can be written log to the base 2, 2 square. Okay, so this can be written as 2 log to the base 2, 12. 4 3s are 12. Log of a plus log of b is log of a into b, which is 12. You can make out 12 plus 9 minus 21 will give you 0. Satisfies. So automatically you can make out that the answer will be B option by substituting this option also. But yes, I prefer approximation. So if you approximate it, you can do your calculation mentally and you can get the answer. But yes, if you move for maybe putting the equations, you can put this equation like this also and get the answer. Either way, whichever way you're comfortable, you can get the answer. So 9 plus 12 minus 21 will give you 0 as the answer. How many factors of 2 raised to 4, 3 raised to 5 and 10 raised to 4? Now for any perfect squares, you need to have even number of powers. So 2 can be 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 2 or 2 raised to 4. Three ways. Say 3 raised to 5 can be 3 raised to 0, 3 raised to 2 or 3 raised to 4 can be the end of factor. Three ways. 10 raised to 4 can be 10 raised to 0, 10 square. Oh no, 10 you have to break it up into 2 and 5. My mistake. So to combine the 5, if you combine the 5, you get 2 raised to 4 into 3 raised to 5 into 2 raised to 4 into 5 raised to 4. This becomes 2 raised to 8 into 3 raised to 5 into 5 raised to 4. Now you can do. 2 can be 2 raised to 0, 2 square up to 2 raised to 8, 2 4, 2 raised to 6, 5 ways. 3 can be 3 raised to 0, 3 square, 3 raised to 4, 3 ways. Same way, 5 can be 5 raised to 0, 5 square, 5 raised to 4, 3 ways. So total number of ways becomes 45 ways. But in this way, there is also one which is there. Because when you don't include any of this, 2 raised to 0, 3 raised to 0, and 5 raised to 0, you get 1. If you remove 1, because they said greater than 1. So automatically the answer will be 44 as the answer. So you get 44. Right? The answer for 18 will be 44. Take 2 raised to 0, 3 raised to 0, 5 raised to 0 is not possible because it has to be more than 1. So we subtract 1 from there. get the answer. The basic funda is for perfect square, the power of factors has to be multiple of 2. The power of prime factor should be a multiple of 2. So we take 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. This will be 6-digit number. The 6, that is the rightmost digit, is the sum of the first 3 digits. The 5th digit is the sum of the first 2 digits. The 3rd digit is equal to the first digit and 2nd digit is twice the first digit. So I can take, let the first digit be A. They said first digit is equal to the 3rd digit. So A and A, the first digit and the 3rd digit is A and A. 2nd digit they have said is twice the first digit. So this becomes 2A, second digit. Now 4, 5, 6, the 6 is 6, that is rightmost digit is sum of the first 3 digits, 4A. 5th digit is sum of the first 2 digits, 3A. And the 3rd, the 4th digit, if you say, is the sum of the 5th and 6th digits, so 7A. So value of A can only be 1 because A is integer. So A can only be 1. A can't be 2. If A is 2, then 7A will be a 2-digit number. Not possible. A has to be only 1. So the 4th digit has to be 7 into 1, which will be 7. Simple sum. You'll always have some simple sums in the examination which you can easily solve. You need to identify. That's the ability. You need to be able to identify easy sums and solve. And leave out the tough sums. If you can do that, it's always great. John jogs a track A at 6 kilometers per hour and B, Mary, so John at 6 kilometers per hour speed and Mary at 7.5 kilometers per hour. John makes 9 rounds, Mary makes 5 rounds. Total is 325 meters. Now try to understand this. More the speed, more the distance run. So that means John 6 and Mary 7.5. The ratio of the distance covered by John is 6 and Mary is 7.5. Right? That's the distance, total distance covered. But John covers 9 rounds. That means per round of the track will be 6 upon 9. And per round of a track of Mary will be 7.5 upon 5. Okay? Because more the rounds, less the length of the track. So length of the track for John A will be 6 upon 9. And for B it will be 7.5 upon 5. If you understand this, then it becomes simple. 2 and 3, 3 and 2, the ratio becomes 4 is to 9. So ratio of the length of track of A and B is 4 and 9, which will get us 13, 4 plus 9, 13. 13 stands for 325. If you look at 13, 25 is a 325. So length of track A will be 4 into 25, which will be 100. So we know length of track A is 100. So Mary runs one round of track A. So Mary runs 100 meters at 7.5 kilometers per hour. Okay. So if I convert to meters per second, 7.5 into 5 upon 18 meters per second. So convert this into. So if you get 5, you get 20. So you get 20 into 18 upon 7.5. You can remove this point and multiply by 10 out here. So 5 2s are, 5 15s are, 15 3s are, 4s are, 3 1s are, 3 6s are. You multiply, you'll get 48 seconds. So 100 meters distance upon speed is equal to time by Mary. Distance here now is 100 meters at the speed of 7.5 kilometers per hour. Just convert kilometers per hour to meters per second and solve. You will get the answer as 48 seconds. Yes, these are the sums which takes little extra time. Normally, a lot of sums in a CAT can be solved really fast without worrying too much. But these take little extra time. Here, I didn't use any exotic formula. I just use the common sense ratios and try to get the answer. And that's what is required in CAT. They expect you to understand the basic fundamentals and use and try to solve. Nothing exotic. If you know the basic fundamentals and if you know some tricks and turns, you can really become fast in the CAT exam. It's not difficult to solve all the questions in the examination in the given time frame. They're not unsolvable, they're solvable. Right? I hope this is clear. Thank you.